God. Look at it. He, contrasting to the Lord, yet thou shalt be brought down to hell to the sides of the pit. Jesus Christ humbled himself, made himself as a man, made himself a stem out of the rod of Jesse. He wore our clothes. He ate our food. He experienced our pain. He experienced our hurt. He was reviled. He was put in situations. He was stripped and was lifted up on a cross, naked, bruised, and beaten, with his hair plucked out and stripes on him. And Peter says, 1 Peter says, that we'll heal by his stripes. Because he become poor, we'll heal. Now, Satan wanted to be the king. He wanted to be the big shot. He wanted to be the ruler. You want to know who's going to be blessed? It's going to be the folks who walk around in servanthood, who looks at the Bible and says, I want to be like our Lord. I want to be like our Christ. When folks revile me, I want to keep my mouth shut, and I just want to honor your name. I just want to hear your word. I just want to walk in your counsel. I want to be your servant. I don't want to make myself of no reputation. I just want the Lord. You know, there are a lot of big shot preachers today who want to build a big reputation in the big kingdom. There are a lot of religious folks today who wants to put themselves up on high. They're acting like they're God. A lot of them preaching on TV today, they're God. They want to build their own little kingdom in this world. I'm not interested in having no kingdom in this world. I have a king. I am rich. I'm rich through Christ. The Christmas season, you can get gifts, you can get things, and those are good, and those are fine, those are dandy. It's good when the kids come. It's the family's a blessing and all that. It's good when they come. It's good when they leave, praise God. But the great thing about the Lord Jesus is that what he's done will never be undone. Amen. And what he gives, it satisfies. Amen. The expectations that Christ has given and I have of him, he fulfilled. He made me rich. He become poor that I might be rich. Now I've got something to tell you this morning, and I want you to listen real close to me. And I'm going to be shutting down here in just a minute or two. I'm going to make a statement here in just a minute. Now, you can rebel, but you will bow to him. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 20 said that God's given him a name that's above every name, that's above every principality, that's above every power. His name is high. Isaiah says that his name is high and lifted up. Now, here's a statement I'm going to make to you this morning. Now, I want you to clean your ears out real good this morning. I want you to listen real close to me this morning. The Bible clearly says that we're going to bow. There's two things we're going to do. Your tongue is going to confess that Jesus is Lord. That's one thing you're going to do. Number two, your knee is going to bow in obedience to the Lord. The Lord Jesus Christ was obedient in everything. He fulfilled the Lord's will. His name is high and lifted up. He's exalted his name above every name. Now there's two things you're going to do. You're going to bow your knee and confess that he's Lord. And your mouth is going to confess it. But it's not a matter of... Now y'all listen real close. Now here's a catch to this. Here's the thing you're going to have to realize this morning. It's not a matter of when you will, but it's a matter of where. Can I say that again? It's a matter of when, but it's a matter of where. Now listen close to me. If you do it in this world, you'll spend eternity in heaven with him. But if you die, and at the great white throne judgment, when your knee bows and says, Lord, you are Lord Jesus. All the folks today that said, don't pray in Jesus' name. All the folks today said, you can do anything except mention Christ. All the folks that cast his name out, one day when they see God, they can say, you are God. You are the Christ. You are the Lord. You are the door. You are the Lamb. But if they wait to that great white throne judgment, it will be too late. The demons in hell are going to confess that Jesus is Lord. Everything in the sea is going to confess that Jesus is Lord. Everything in heaven is going to confess that Jesus is Lord. Every name in heaven, earth, sea, under the earth, and on the earth is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. His name is high and lifted up. Amen. Now here's the problem. Here's the situation. Listen real close to me. You can either confess it today and live for eternity and believe in your heart that God raised the Son from the dead and be saved today. Or you can put it off and say, I'm not going to confess Him. I'm not going to believe Him. But grant it. You will one day bow and say, You're Lord. But if you wait, to that final judgment day, it'll be too late. It's a matter of where. Not a matter of when, but where. You can do it now, but if you do it then, it's going to be too late. Would you this morning think about this? As you stand with me this morning, you will do it. It's a matter of where. You can do it here. But if you wait, it'll be too late. This morning, the invitation will continue. If you've never humbled your heart and said, Jesus, You're Lord, if you've never asked Him into your heart and said, Lord, I want to be saved, if you've never done that this morning, the invitation will continue. After we leave here today, the Holy Spirit may still call you. It's going to continue. However, there will be one day when the Spirit will not call you. The Bible says, my spirit will not always contend with men. There will be a day when you die. There will be a day when mentally you cannot accept the Lord. But you heard today. Today is the day of salvation. Don't put off confessing Him as Lord this morning. Those of you that are saved and you've confessed Jesus as Lord before in your life, praise God. Those of you who's never confessed Him as Lord this morning, don't be embarrassed here, because one day you're going to stand before millions, billions. And you might say, you know, I remember way back when I was on that side of eternity, I was in a little church. It was in Elizabeth, Louisiana. And the Holy Spirit dealt with me. You know, I've never confessed Jesus as Lord. I've never said I'm a sinner. I should have, but I didn't. And now I'm going to have to spend eternity with demons and lost men. I missed the Lord. Don't miss Him today. The Holy Spirit is calling us today. Can I say to you this morning, I'm rich this morning. I'm rich this morning. It's not because nothing I've ever done. It's because what Jesus did for me. I'm rich this morning because He took my sin. And judicially, He took my sin and paid it. He paid a debt I couldn't pay. This morning as we sing, if you're lost this morning, would you come up and say, I need the Lord. I want to be saved. I'm lost. I want to confess Jesus as Lord this morning. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed to come up and confess Jesus as Lord this morning. Why are we here this morning? We're here to find Him and to know Him. Let Him fill your heart with the riches of Him today. Read Psalms 22 and you go home today and give God the glory and give Him the praise as we sing.